You know, we were one of the first crews that actually got on the ground here. And as we first came into town, as you said, we knew 10 Highway was shut down here with the power line. So actually, even before nightfall came, we took a back road into the center of town. You know, you talk about cliches a lot in these kinds of storms. You talk about maybe a bomb going off or it looks like a war zone. All of that was very apt when we arrived on the scene here in Norborne. And I want to show you some video of a building that collapsed. This is a building that was built here in Norborne in 1903, and it's right next to Larry's Auto Shop. Now, this building, Larry knew that it was not as stable as he would have liked it to be. Nonetheless, he said these were 100-mile-an-hour straight-line winds, and he said they were simply no match for this storm. The interesting thing about it is there were several cars that were parked behind here, and in some of this video, you're going to see an old Chevy truck that is absolutely just buried under all these bricks. All right, we tracked this storm as it came across I-29 from the state of Kansas, and we were following it the whole time. John Woods, the photographer, he's a trained weather spotter. He was talking about the fact that he thought this was going to be juicy and it was going to build up at some point. And when it did, it would definitely pack some powerful winds. We caught up with some kids who are from Plattwoods Church in Plattwoods, Missouri. They were at a church retreat over in Lawson, Missouri. Listen to the man who runs that camp describe exactly what he saw and heard.
The wind, we could begin to hear the rains come. We were sitting on the back porch with a metal deck, metal roof, and we could begin to hear the rain come. And then all of a sudden, the winds picked up and the trees were bending over and touching the ground. And we had...
Now, Dennis says that he had some 50 kids in the camp. He said all of them were doing just fine. They had basements for all of them to go to. Nonetheless, this is camp season. Laura knows that well. She just had a son who returned from Boy Scout camp. So it is a very scary time for parents. Real quickly, let me show you MGE trucks just arriving here on the scene. This is the latest wave. Obviously, Bev's been talking about the fact that emergency crews are rolling into town here in Norborne, Missouri tonight. So that is the situation from Norborne here tonight. We're going to wrap it up for now. And of course, we'll have much more on First News tomorrow morning. Laura, Kelly, back to you in the studio.